In the last video, we went over an event known as the drilling of the bore. The bore was not large enough to allow the Dark One to escape, but it was large enough to allow him to touch the world. His touch subtly altered everything that came within its influence. The period of around 100 years after the drilling of the bore is known as the Collapse. During the Collapse, some people began to side with the Dark One. Channelers that joined the Dark One were called Dreadlords, or the Forsaken. Over time, the term Forsaken has come to be used specifically for the 13 most powerful of the Dreadlords. Today, we are going to take a look at Lanfear. Lanfear was not always her name. Lanfear used to go by the name Myron Arenal. According to the world of the Wheel of Time, Myron was in a relationship with Louis Theron Telamon, the dragon. According to Grendel, Lanfear was so obsessed with Louis Theron Telamon that she would do whatever he asked of her. Moiraine believes that Lanfear loved Louis Theron, but Louis Theron would disagree. Louis Theron believes that Lanfear did not have the ability to love another because her heart was claimed already by the desire for power. So basically, Louis Theron and Myron were in a relationship, but eventually, Louis broke it off since she appeared to love the association with him more than she loved him as a person. But Myron did not give up on him. Myron drilled the bore, which allowed the Dark One's influence to touch the world, a period of around 100 years known as the Collapse. Meanwhile, Louis Theron had met, fell in love with, and got married to Ilyena. Myron attempted to disrupt their wedding, and over the following year, she made several blatant public approaches to Louis Theron, blaming Ilyena for her loss of him. Shortly after this, Myron embraced the Shadow. According to the world of the Wheel of Time, Myron went to the Shadow and claimed her own name, Lanfear, which means Daughter of the Night in the Old Tongue. Lanfear is the only Forsaken to have chosen her own name. And fun fact, the Forsaken do not refer to themselves as Forsaken. They think of themselves as the Chosen, chosen to rule the world forever. Lanfear was tall and slender with pale skin. She had dark eyes that were bottomless pools. Her hair fell in perfect black waves to her shoulders, and it was often decorated by silver stars and crescents that go along with her name, Lanfear, Daughter of the Night. According to Ravine, she was as beautiful as he was handsome. When seeing her, most men would have felt their mouths go dry with desire. So basically, Lanfear is considered the most beautiful woman of her age or any other age. According to Ravine, Lanfear was untrustworthy and her temper was uncertain at best. And in terms of her tactics, Lanfear was never one for attacking openly. She preferred the flanks and the rear. She liked to do her work in the shadows, so to say. So she was never a field commander, but she was still very useful to the Dark One both before and during the War of the Shadow. One of her best tactics was to use dreams. Using dreams, Lanfear guided a number of operations that turned people against established authority, creating massive riots. She is credited with winning several battles for the Shadow by the same means. Lanfear is also credited with driving a number of people mad and driving others to suicide, as well as performing outright assassinations in Teleron Riode, the Dream World. Lanfear also served as a governor of conquered territory at least once. During that time, she was involved in many atrocities, perhaps more than most of the Forsaken, but the people she governed had more than the usual horrors of the Shadow to face. They feared sleep itself. Suicide rates were extremely high in her territory. And last but not least, Lanfear was a key asset to the Shadow because she had an intimate knowledge of the dragon, Louis Theron Telamon. So that's Lanfear. She's incredibly beautiful. She once dated Louis Theron, but he broke that off. She was so obsessed with him that she tried to disrupt his wedding and never gave up on pursuing him. Lanfear was one of the researchers who drilled into the bore, causing the collapse. When she joined the Shadow, she chose her own name, Lanfear. She is the only Forsaken to have chosen her own name. Lanfear is untrustworthy, she has a temper, and she does a lot of her work in the Shadows and in the Dream World. And most notably, Lanfear loves nothing as much as she loves power. Not Louis Theron Telamon, and not even the Dark One himself. So love her or hate her, Lanfear is a major player in the turning of the Wheel of Time.